Not so much a question, but a discernment. Can a women's prayer be different from men's prayer, or prayer is something that's unified, that we are aspiring towards in our effort, in our results?
Nope, there's no difference, practically. Of course, there's a difference if you take, in our world, a female body versus a man's, and you can study their functionality and characteristics. You'll find that this is female and this is male. Just like 1,000 years ago, if we discover some kind of body, we can still say that it was female or male, even if there's nothing left physically. But fiber is something else, cloth. So we feel the world differently, we are created differently, and we have different spiritual roots, the men and the women. So there is a difference. But right now, and in general, it doesn't depend on us at all. We must ask the Creator to be united and to rise above our egoistic nature together, the women's group and the men's group together, because a tent of women is not a tent of men based on their internal parameters. We'll see this in the future. The difference is great. And Kabbalah, a clear boundary is defined between male and female beginning, and it stays this way until the end. We won't understand each other. Only in the spiritual world, by working together for the sake of the Creator, and through the Creator we connect to each other, then through the Creator we'll begin to understand each other. Otherwise, we don't understand each other and won't. You can talk to psychologists as much as they get it. It's clear to us that we can't work together. But, however, we can in the same direction. Men and women separately, while helping each other, collaborating in these external actions on the level of our world. But for this to not, under any circumstances, disturb the yearning of the hearts to the Creator.
France.